This is Matthew Bowling. Many see him as the future of American sprinting, and it's easy to see why. In 2019, he had one of the greatest track and field campaigns in history, as he maintained an undefeated season over multiple disciplines, and he became the first high school athlete to ever run under 10 seconds for the 100-meter dash. In addition to his sprinting dominance, he also achieved great success in the long jump, with one jump in particular going just over 8 meters in length. This was the furthest high school long jump in over a decade, and it only further displayed Bowling's unbelievable athletic capabilities. This versatility is what makes Bowling so compelling, because even though he's certainly one of the most exciting and promising young sprinters in the world, his raw athleticism is certainly the absolute elite of the elite. To the surprise of no one, Bowling was awarded the National Gatorade Track and Field Athlete of the Year for his senior year of high school, signifying once again that he was on another level for track and field excellence. After his high school graduation, he continued his quest for track and field dominance, and just like he did throughout his entire senior year, he made winning seem almost inevitable. In June of 2019, he competed at the United States Under-20 Championships, which brings out many of the nation's most promising young athletes, both in high school and in college. Although he was still only 18 years old at the time, he won both the 100 and the 200 meters, and he won both events easily. In the 100 meter finals, he ran a time of 10.15 seconds, which put him a full stride length ahead of his closest competitor. In the 200 meters, he was once again unstoppable, as he won the race by over 2/10 of a second. This was certainly an exciting and dominant start to his summer. However, Matthew Bowling was just getting started. At the Under-20 Pan American Championships, he was once again poised to run some of his fastest times ever, and although this was his first real test on the international scene, his racing exploits left many in complete shock. In the 100 meters, the 200 meters, the 4x1, and the 4x400 meter relay, he brought home 4 gold medals, and in both of his relay races, he broke the under-20 world records with incredible times of 38.62 seconds for the 4x1 and a time of 2 minutes 59.30 seconds for the 4x4. He also managed to improve on his personal bests in both the 100 and the 200 meters, running times of 10.11 for the 100 and 20.31 for the 200 meters. This was yet another moment of surreal success, as he now defeated not just the best competition in his country, but in the entire world. Heading into college, he enrolled at the University of Georgia, where he was expected to continue in both sprinting and in jumping. And just like his senior year of high school, he was still a true running celebrity. At the start of the season, he appeared in a video with the University of Georgia football team, where he raced against a fellow football player in a relay race. And just like many previous races, he managed to defeat this athlete like it was nothing. As the year progressed, he maintained an almost untouchable athletic profile, as his elite training was documented in multiple outlets throughout his first semester. Finally, as the 2020 track and field season began, Bowling's hopes were aimed at the 2020 Olympic trials, where just maybe he could make the Olympic team as a freshman in college. Unfortunately, after an unprecedented turn of events, the entire world suspended all track races, leaving Bowling with many unanswered questions. Although his season unfortunately got cut very short, we did have the opportunity to see Bowling compete during the indoor season, and the truth of these performances is absolutely stunning. On January 12th of 2020, Bowling ran his collegiate debut at Clemson University in the 60-meter dash. In his very first collegiate finals performance, he ran a time of 6.68 seconds for the 60-meter dash, putting him third on the all-time list at the University of Georgia. This was actually quite remarkable, especially given that he was still a true freshman and he was only 19 years old. Additionally, Bowling typically takes a few strides to get into his racing, but somehow he still managed to run a very respectable time in this rather short racing distance. This performance was indeed a powerful start to his collegiate career, and true greatness was definitely just around the corner for Bowling. Just 1 month later, on February 15th, he once again proved that he was a formidable opponent for all competition. At the Tyson Invitational in Fayetteville, Arkansas, Bolling set out to race the 200 meters. Based on his previous performances, expectations were quite high, but once again, Bolling did not disappoint. In the finals, he ran a superior time of 20.66 seconds, which was easily a new school record at the University of Georgia. Then, once again, just 2 weeks later, he ran another great race at the SEC Championships, where he placed second overall with a time of 20.71 seconds. All of these performances were certainly fantastic, but there is another reason why each of these races were even more incredible than most realize. Unlike many other athletes, Bolling had a specific goal for 2020, and that was to reach his best fitness in the summer, as the Olympic trials were originally slated for June of 2020. This means that for his early performances during his collegiate career, he was just beginning to show his true fitness, and out of nowhere, the season was cut short. I can only imagine what his 2020 campaign would have looked like if everything would have gone normally. However, given that the Olympic trials are now scheduled for 2021, this one-year postponement could very well make Bolling one of the biggest threats in both the 100 and the 200 meters, and who knows, maybe even the long jump. With his current personal bests, it would be quite challenging for Bolling to make the Olympic team. In both the 100 and the 200, he will almost certainly need to run under 10 seconds and under 20 seconds in order to make the team. And although he was already beginning to show some improvements, achieving these times against the nation's greatest competition by June of 2020 would have been a monumental task for Bolling. Since the start of the pandemic shutdown, he has posted a few times on social media, broadcasting multiple clips showcasing his amazing fitness. On March 18th, he showed his raw strength while lifting weights. On March 5th, he showed the more technical side of his 100-meter start, as he posted this slow-motion side-view video. And most recently, on May 8th, he showcased his incredible abilities in the long jump, as he somehow managed to jump over 80 plastic cups into the long jump pit. Now, I did some research here. Each plastic cup is typically 9.5 centimeters in diameter at the top, and if 80 of these cups are placed directly in a line, that would yield a total distance of 7.6 meters, or just under 25 feet. However, it's also very likely that there's just a little bit of space between each cup, which would probably make this jump closer to 7.70 meters, as opposed to 7.6. Either way, Bolling's red solo cup jump was a very unique way to look at how he soars through the air, and although competition is still postponed, it's great to see that Bolling is finding unique ways to stay fit and motivated. Moving on from the jumping, Bolling's chances of making the Olympic team in 2021 are certainly higher than they would have been in 2020. And as we previously stated, he'll almost certainly need to be under 10 seconds for the 100 meters, and under 20 or perhaps right around 20 seconds for the 200. In 2016 at the Olympic trials, both sprinting events were very much reflecting this reality. And in other Olympic trials, we saw a very similar situation, with runners achieving times of just under 10 seconds for the 100, and either under 20 or right at 20 seconds for the 200 meters. Indeed, qualification will be a big challenge for Bolling, but it certainly is more possible with the postponement. I do believe he had a decent chance of making the Olympic team for 2020, but if he can continue to improve and continue showcasing his incredible athleticism, Matthew Bolling very well might become an Olympian in 2021. And now I pass the question off to you. Will Bolling make the Olympic team in 2021, and what event will be his specialty? Will he qualify in the 100 meters, where he has a personal best of 10.11 seconds? Will he make the team in the 200 meters, where he has a personal best of 20.31 seconds? Or will he become an Olympian in another event, such as the 400 meters or the long jump, where he has excellent personal bests as well? Leave a comment down below and share your thoughts on how you believe Matthew Bolling will qualify for the Olympic Games. Thanks for watching, everyone, and as always, until next time.